We're going to look at a difference between two words that we keep using many a times, and this is very important. And the first part of this verse is Proverbs chapter 11, verse 3. Proverbs chapter 11, verse 3. And here it is, the New King James Version on the screen. The integrity of the upright will guide them, but the perversity of the unfaithful will destroy them. The integrity of upright will guide them. Please be seated. God bless you. So we will look at two words today, and we will look at what does Bible want us to focus on. One is character, the other one is personality. Are both the same? You can say yes, no, maybe. You know, there are only three answers. If you're confident, you will say yes. If you don't have a clue, you will say no. If you're in between, you will say maybe. Right? Is there a difference between character and personality? Silence is that we accept or reject, or there is a difference. And we will see what it is. While the New International Version uses the word character in place of integrity in the Bible. Originally, when the Bible was written, Old Testament in Hebrew and New Testament in Greek, I keep reading a lot of commentaries and go back to the history of all of it. So there's a lot of effort in that sense. And it's not just effort, it's enriching when you keep digging and trying to understand. Bible commentators say that originally the word character was not mentioned. And Bible used two words to define character. One is this word called integrity, and the other one is virtue, which is Proverbs 31. It speaks about the virtuous woman, right? Especially Women's Day, they read that. And beautiful description. We'll quickly see what these two are about and what is happening these days. And even as I was meditating, I could clearly reflect about the deception of looking at the outward, because it is more about a person. We use this word, what a personality, you know. And lot of us, including me, have had our own impressions based on the personality of an individual. And unfortunately, we don't get to know the character of that person. And that is where we are misled. And at least I've had some very, very bitter experiences, both within the ministry and more so outside. As most of you know, I'm still working and God has led me to a very good position. I don't have to really talk about that. But with that comes accountability, with that comes responsibility, and with that comes understanding people to be able to see. And as I was meditating, I could clearly realize that I was mistaken many a times, and I sought God's pardon. I don't know, these days we look up Webster dictionary and so on and so forth. There are so many dictionaries, and this is straight from that Webster, the word integrity, and I don't want to add my own words. It is very simple and clear. It says integrity is an unimpaired condition, or the next is easy to understand, a sound adherence to a code of moral values and the quality or a state of being complete and undivided. Beautiful. A sound adherence to moral values. That is what integrity is all about. And the verse that we read, the part of that verse, which is Proverbs 11:3, it says that integrity is doing something. What is that word there? Integrity of the upright will, what? Highlight that word, what? Guide. The values that you carry, the values that I adhere to, are going to become the guiding factor of my life. And we as believers of Lord Jesus Christ must derive those values not from the world, but from the Word. Right? Yes, no? Because those values are going to drive me. And that is what is integrity all about. The greatest example of the many from the Bible is Joseph. Right? Always is appealing to a lot of young people. And not just young people, anybody. If you see his life, we know his life. He was a person of integrity. He didn't compromise. And the greatest test came, which is his character test. Right? Yes, no? Is when he was in Potiphar's house. When Potiphar looked at him and for the values that he carried. He was a slave. He was brought as a slave. But was given in charge of his entire household. And his wife starts to tempt him, and we know. Because of those values, because of that integrity, because of that character, because of that virtue, Joseph ran away, was imprisoned, and we know all that story. So we will see first, quickly, three things with the limited time that we have. The first one is the difference between character and personality. And we'll look at one example in the Bible, I don't have to even explain. If you just read those, we'll have to read 4 or 5 verses, which we will. And we can clearly see what is personality and what is character. Before that, the small illustration of the many. There was this man and he had a son. And both of them had a small little shop just away from the main town. And the father's practice, it was not when internet and all were there, that while they were going to their small little shop, which is outside the city, they used to stop at a newspaper store, and that store used to sell a couple of other things, to pick up that day's newspaper every day and go to their shop. During the day, they kind of used to read, and that was their routine. So every day, he goes to the shop along with his son, pays that money for that newspaper, picks up the newspaper and goes. One day, he did the same thing. He went, he paid the money, he picked up the newspaper, he went to his shop. And when they reached the shop, he realized that instead of taking one copy of the newspaper, he picked up two. That's all. He realized that, you know, this is not right. And he felt that, because he goes there every day, let me go back. When I go back tomorrow, I will pay for the extra copy that I have taken. But something within him told, if I go tomorrow, you know, today, this person will definitely form an opinion about me that I have taken an extra copy. Either I have stolen that, so I think it is not right. Let me go back immediately. He went back immediately, returned that copy. It's not expensive. It's a couple of rupees. But he gave back saying that, you know, in my hurry, I picked up two copies, but I paid only for one, so please take it. That man was impressed. He went back. Again, next day he comes, he does this. After 1 week, there is an article in the newspaper saying that there was a theft that happened in that store. Somebody stole money from that newspaper store. And obviously police came and they checked during what time this money was missing. And they zeroed in and understood that there were only two people who came around that time. One was this person who returned the newspaper, the other was somebody else. Without doubt, the shopkeeper said, this person is probably not the thief. Why? Because a week back, he returned one newspaper. His store is too far away. He came back all the way just to return one newspaper. So he cannot be that thief. Later on, they zeroed in. They found the other person to be the thief. That is what is integrity. Are you getting it? That is what is character. Character should be built. Character is developed. Personality is what I am. I can't do anything about it. That is the difference between personality and you and I are born with a personality. Are you getting it? Short, fat, dark, medium, large, extra large, and certain qualities around that. That is your personality. This is my personality. And a lot of people these days are all that they're doing, and there's a lot of techniques that are being told in a lot of workshops trying to polish personality. Pardon me for using that word. But when I sit in these sessions, it's all about how do it's about grooming and all of this. What is this? This is just polishing your personality. But nobody talks about developing your character. Because there cannot be a drastic change in your personality. Because that is what you're born with. But because of the grace of God, when we are saved, God wants to develop His character in you and me. Are you getting it? And that is what we should stand for. And that is what you and I should focus on. Charles Swindoll, great man of God, said, reputation is what people think you are. Character is what you are regardless of what people think about you. Irrespective of whatever they think. So my character is a matter of my choice. My personality is hereditary. It passes on from generation to generation. But your character and my character is a choice. And character is towards God and towards man. It is both ways. Personality, for a large extent, is towards man, towards people. And I'll give you one illustration or one verse. And that is where Samuel, the prophet, also kind of was mistaken. When the children of Israel started to compare themselves with other kingdoms, and they said, everybody else, our enemies, have kings, but we don't have a king. God's desire was to lead them through prophets. But then these people complained, no, we need a king. So God says, Samuel, you go to Jesse's children and pick up. Right? We know that story. And no, that is for Samuel. And then before that, 1 Samuel chapter 9 and verse 1 and 2. And that is when he was to choose David. But when he goes to choose Saul, 1 Samuel chapter 9 verse, here he is. If you go to verse 2 of yeah. And he had a choice and handsome son whose name was Saul. There was not a more what? Handsome person than he among the children of Israel. From his shoulder upwards, he was taller than any of the people. Is this character or personality? Loudly? Clear? That is God-given personality. But we know the kind of character King Saul displayed. Right? And he lost his kingdom. He fell in the sight of God. So many a times, we are impressed both within the religious realm and also outside. And as human beings, we are carried away by the personality of people. But don't ever do that. There could be a lot of great personalities, but people of low character. I don't want to name them from here. We keep reading about such people in the newspapers. You can clearly relate to what we are trying to learn today. So that is the difference. So now let us come to the core of today's message. If character is so important that God wants to develop his character in his children, and character should be built, character should be developed, and I need to make a choice and ask God to help me build that godly character. Let us look at a few examples of how this character is developed. Now that we understood the difference between what? Personality and character. I'll tell you another illustration. There was this man who went to KFC and brought something as a takeaway. You know, KFC, McDonald's and all, they have these covers and they keep it there. So he came along with a woman and he ordered whatever it is. And there was a lot of rush that day, so there were covers there and he picked up one cover, thought that it was his order, and he went away with this woman that he came. After they reached their destination, they opened, probably they wanted to see nuggets or whatever. They saw it was full of cash. This lady who was at the counter was not keeping cash in the counter. She was putting it in one of those covers. So in the hurry, this guy picked up that cover. It was not intentional. It was, hey, this is a big mistake, you know. So they drove back. It took probably 1-2 hours. They came back and went to that counter and they said, ma'am, do you know that? I said, yeah. You know, we took this instead of that order. It's full of cash. Please take it. She was like, nobody ever does this. And she called her manager and all. And people are, the ones who are working there wanted to, you know, take a photograph and publish an article saying that, you know, these people took this entire money, but they came back and said, please, please, please don't do that. She's not my wife. So is that integrity? He had a personality to come back and give the money, but when it came to his character, he was going around with somebody else while he was already married to someone. That is not character. Are you getting it? So character is, in any situation, you will remain the same. And that is, I don't want to talk about this, but I can still say, hopefully, that there are great personalities when you look at politicians. The rest is left to your imagination. Politicians are, we cannot generalize, but most of them are so good in polishing their personality and to present, and you and I are impressed. But what are they made of? Only God knows. Unfortunately. Or so many others. Unfortunately, there are a couple of men of God who use their God-given personality to keep deceiving people. And no character is built. And it is a tragedy. I have heard couple of church members who've come here, who are part of some other church, when they shared certain things about the previous pastor or the evangelist or whoever, it was heartbreaking. And the answer to that is lack of character, great personality. And it is God's desire that he wants to develop his character in you and me. So we need to focus on building our character based on his word, based on this truth, based on the values that the word, heaven and earth will pass away, but his word will remain the same. So may this be that foundation. May not the world dictate how we need to develop ourselves, but we say, Lord, we trust your word, so build my character, O God, based on your word. One great man of God, Dr. Tom Malkwan, was the founder president of the college at Midwest Pontiac in Michigan. And their advertisement was a character building factory. Wow. A character building factory was their tagline of their college. And he says that I owe it to God and then to this college that instilled discipline, diligence, duty, and determination into my life. And that is what is building character. Church, friends, brothers, sisters, focus on building your character. When we are born again, we are what? A new creation. We are born again into the family of God. And God wants to develop you. Irrespective of whatever personality you have, don't worry. John the Baptist didn't have an impressive personality. And they say Saul was also not having a great personality. I mean, if people looked at him, they would say, there are a lot of great men and women of God who were just not impressive. Either they were, you know, very lean or short or didn't look nice. And when they got onto the pulpit, people had an impression about what will this person share. But the moment they start sharing God's word, it's like, wow! That is God-given character and the power of the Holy Spirit that works in you and me. I'm not telling you don't use your personality, but don't focus as much and don't worry so much about this outward appearance that people are so bothered about. And as D.L. Moody says, another great man of God, that character is developed in a closet. That is when you're alone with God. And when you sit with him. And this is what David said in Psalm 26. And I'll quickly show you David's son, Absalom, about how he tried to manipulate. And that is the stark difference between character and personality. Psalm 26, verse 1. This is what David says in that psalm. Here it is. Vindicate me or judge me, O Lord, for I have walked in what? Integrity. I have also trusted in the Lord. I will not slip. As we saw in the beginning, character in Bible is a combination of two words. One is integrity. The second one is virtue, as mentioned in Proverbs 31. Now we'll look at Absalom for a minute and we'll quickly look at 2-3 other lives, just few verses, and with that we close to understand. We saw the difference between character and personality. We are looking at how do you develop that personality, that character that God has given you. That when we have given our lives to thee in the morning, I spoke about repentance. And I spoke about continuing when we looked at Acts chapter 2 verse 42 and the early church after Peter stood up and gave the first sermon by the power of the Holy Spirit in Acts 2. And when he finished his message, people there were convicted within their hearts and they'll ask this question, what shall we do? And he says, repent and be baptized. And by the way, today we had 10 people who had taken baptism. Hallelujah. Can you give a clap of glory for God? 10 people. Throughout, as most of you know, throughout the year we keep giving baptisms. We don't limit it to Easter, New Year first day. The day you are convinced and convicted within, and if somebody walks up and say, we've accepted Jesus as our Savior and we want to get baptized, we'll take 1 or 2 weeks just to announce so that there could be others, and then we go about giving baptism. It could be 1, 5, 10, whatever, throughout the year. And baptisms are given only when they share their testimony and they clearly say that have gone through this true experience of what it means to repent and being forgiven near the foot of the cross and have cleansed their sins in the blood of Jesus Christ. And if they have any doubt, then we counsel them further and we say, take your time. And then, so it's amazing. So in the morning, during the two services in Telugu, I was just focusing on that early church continued. And Christian life is about continuing. Looking unto Jesus, the author and finisher of our faith, and running this race, right? And to finish. I always keep telling, Christian race is not about competing. It is about completing. Yes, no? Commonwealth Games just finished, right? And there were so many people who competed, but there are only, every event they have only 3 medals. Gold, silver, bronze. No consolation also. And then I would have also participated. Right? And even in colleges and schools and offices and all, there is forced ranking. They'll say you're in the top 10%, bottom 5%, whatever it is. Right? Here it's all about competing and comparing. Right? But when it comes to God's kingdom, it is all about completing. Amazing. That is why Paul says, I have run the race and I have finished. Right? And I am waiting. So it's all about finishing. And God doesn't say first, second, third, fourth. It's on the lighter side. If at all God would have said there are prizes there, even in heaven there would have been trouble. While that will not happen. Somebody will say, how come Peter Samuel got this? I did more than him. Talk to my people who are there, still there, down in heaven. Call them. WhatsApp, SMS. That's why everyone who completes is a winner. Hallelujah. Everyone who completes. All that matters is, are you completing with faith in Christ? Because that is what Jesus said, when I come back, will I find people with faith? In the end days, lot of people will fall away from faith. Those are the signs of end days. And he says, that's why Paul said, I have kept my faith. I have fought the good fight and I have kept my faith. And I have finished this race. And I'm looking forward. Amazing. So Christian life is about continuing. And as you focus on Jesus and as you are continuing, as you and I surrender ourselves, our focus should be on Lord. This is your character. That is what worship is all about. Right? Worship is about who He is. And He is my Father, right? Since I am born again. He is my Father, as we say, when we look at children, He is exactly photocopy of His father, photocopy of His grandmother, or whoever it is. Why are they saying that? One is personality and certain characteristics that they find. Because you are born in that family, because you are in that same blood relation, right? And similarly, when you and I are born again, then there needs to be that resemblance as children of God, as sons and daughters of the living God, as we are part of God's family. People should say, wow, And that is what God is focused about. And you and I should be focused about developing that godly character. You say, Lord, build me. I am focusing on that. Quickly, we are losing time. We'll go to 2 Samuel chapter 15, verse 2 to 6. Here is Absalom. What was Absalom's desire? He wanted to topple his father. No, think about it. And he is trying to gain the sympathy of people. So see how cleverly he plays. This is a classic example of personality and no character. Thus says the Lord. This is 2 Samuel, please. 2 Samuel 15 chapter. Yes. Now Absalom would rise early and stand beside the way of the gate. He's in the strategic position because everybody comes from the gate. There'll be some people to impress others, no? So it was, whenever anyone had a lawsuit, came to the king. Who is the king? King is David. For a decision, that Absalom would call him to say, in between, this one is there, come here. What city are you from? And he would say, your servant is from such and such, a tribe of Israel. Then you go on. Go to the next verses, please, quickly. Then Absalom would say to him, look, your case is good and right, but there is no deputy of the king to hear you. That means he's telling something against this. No? There is nobody. Actually, I am there, but my dad now doesn't look at me. What is this? And if you see, Absalom was a handsome person, right? The word of God says, long hair, now don't start growing hair. That's okay, that's your choice. But he, and finally, that's what, you know, happens to him. The hair gets entangled and he dies a horrible death. Moreover, Absalom would say, oh, that I were made judge. Right? This is what happens, you know. Sometimes when you sit in your office and during lunchtime, somebody goes, 5 years I've been working. In 2 years, they got 2 promotions. Actually, I only taught this boss how to work. Now he became my boss. Before you say anything like this, think about what people will talk about your personality. Right? And we have God-given character. That means to say, I don't have to compare with anybody. Hallelujah. I will do that which is right in the sight of God. And anyone who has any suit or cause would come to me, then I would give justice. And so it was, whenever anybody came near to bow to him, that he would put on his hand and take him and kiss him. So, what is happening? With all of this, he's gaining what? Popularity. What is the intention? Not to really do some favor for these people. By doing all of this, he will have a lot of people backing him. Because of that support, he wanted to topple his father. That is what his personality. And people will, in this manner, Absalom acted towards all Israel who came to the king for judgment. Look at that word. So Absalom stole the hearts of the men of Israel. They said, "Are what nice person. He meets, he talks, he wants to do good. But what is the intention inside? He wants to become the king." That's how this world is. That is how a lot of people at work are. I'm not discounting that. But you are not like that. I am not supposed to be like that. Because each one of us are people of what? Character. And we are God's children. And let us focus on developing that character. While 100 people in the organization or somewhere else keep doing whatever it takes to get it, some promotion or whatever, you say, no, I'm not part of that because I'm his child. We are not here to garner support of others. We need his support and favor in our lives. And character does not change irrespective of whatever circumstances you are in. Another classic example, while we don't have time, which we are aware of, is Daniel. Do you agree? A man of integrity. He was also a slave, along with his 3 friends. whose names were changed to Shadrach, Meshach, Abednego. And we know that when they were asked to bow, those people didn't bow. And all others, as Daniel kept growing in the corporate ladder, if he was in this kind of setting, he was getting to the highest level. And they were just wanting to catch him. And they said, nowhere they could find anything wrong. And they said, anything around his beliefs. And they said, oh, he prays three times. Let us. They cleverly told the king to pass an order that nobody in this full month should not pray to any other god. But the word of God says, amazing. Daniel, as usual, it amazes me. That is like nothing has changed. If I were to be in Daniel's place, honestly, in the presence of God, I'll say, first I'll go to my home, I'll say, Lord, you know my heart. We are very clever. You know, I am praying only to you. But if somebody sees, I'll be in a problem. So I'll close the window, but I'll pray to you only. You are a very understanding God. I love you, you love me too. Get into some kind of a compromise with God. Daniel, as usual, opened those windows towards Jerusalem and he prayed. He was put in that lion's den. We know. The king couldn't sleep. Think about it. The king was disturbed all night. Early in the morning, before anybody, the king came. Daniel, he said, ah, yes, hello, boss. Think about it. That is character. Irrespective of whatever personality he had. So a God-given character, a character that is built by, that is being built by God, will not yield to any kind of pressure. We are living in a very, very pressure-filled environment. There's no doubt. There is so much of pressure at work, at home, to compromise, to just put our values aside and say, this is how, you know, the world is, so we have to keep doing. But remember the Daniels and the Josephs and so many others. Our God is the same. He's the same yesterday, today, and forever. And he is with you and with me. So we'll say, Lord, we will not compromise. So we saw the difference between personality and character. We looked at the development of character, how we need to develop by focusing on the word, by focusing on who he is and what I'm called for, and allowing him to work in my life and surrendering my circumstances to him and say, Lord, please, I need your help, I need your strength, so that I can stand firm and not try to impress people like Absalom did, just to gain the popularity among people, just to gain some popularity among your organization. Don't do anything like that. It's okay. Others are seeing the outside, but God is seeing the inside. And few examples of people who displayed this character, this integrity. I'll just give you those verses. We've come to the close. another wonderful man of God, the one who lost everything in a single day. Who is that? You know the answer. Job. One day, in few hours, lost everything. And if you see in Job chapter 2 verse 3, the words that are written, Job 2 verse 3. Then the Lord said to Satan, have you considered my servant Job? And there is none like him on the earth. A blameless, what? An upright man, one who fears God, shuns evil. And still he holds fast to his, what? Integrity. Although you enticed me against him to destroy him without cause. Without reason. This is God's testimony. He is a person of integrity. Same book. Chapter 27 verse 5. Job chapter 27 verse 5. Far be it from me that I should say you are right. Till I die, what? I will not put away my integrity. Put away my integrity from me. So many men I've shown. No, I'll show one woman. Ruth. Ruth and the book of Ruth. A Moabite. Chapter 3, verse 1. Ruth chapter 3, verse 1. Here it is. Then Naomi, her mother-in-law, said to her, "My daughter, shall I not seek security for you that you may be well?" Verse 11, please. "Well with you." And here it is. I said there are two words in the Bible about character. One is integrity. The other one is virtue. And now, my daughter, do not fear. I will do for you all that you request. For all the people of my town know that you are a virtuous woman." What a testimony. A virtuous woman. So if you and I are having a godly character and our focus is on developing godly character and we are asking God to develop that character, that means that I should surrender myself. That means I should completely cooperate with God because it is God's work in me. He that began that good work, He is shaping me into His likeness. So I need to surrender myself, that I factor of me, put it to death. Few things that people of character are known for. People of godly character, let me add that word. If you and I display godly character, we don't seek to take revenge. That is one quality of the many. Classic example is Joseph. When he becomes the prime minister, we know he's in a position to settle score with his brothers, right? Because they sold him. They wanted to kill him. They sold him to slavery and all of that. Now they are coming to him. But finally, when he shows himself, and after the death of Jacob, he says, "Don't worry. You meant it for my evil, but God meant it for my good. And I will not do anything." That is character. Not seeking to take revenge. And most importantly, if you have, and if I display godly character, let us remember that none of us will be perfect because there is sin in this flesh. Men of character are not men and women of character doesn't mean that they are perfect. Because you are living in a sinful world, but that doesn't mean that you continue to sin. But when you sin as a child of God, while there is no need, if you are a man and woman of character, like David when he sinned, you'll go back and seek His forgiveness and repent and say, "Lord, help me never do this again." That is what His character all about. And this one verse, as Samuel is choosing the next king, here in this verse, you can see clearly what God is telling. And with that, I close. 1 Samuel chapter 16, verse 7. This is what God said to Samuel. 1 Samuel chapter 16, verse 7. "But the Lord said to Samuel, 'Do not look at his appearance.'" In the bracket, you write personality. Right? Personality is what appears on the outside. Right? "Or at his physical stature," personality, "because I have refused him. For the Lord does not see as a man sees. For the man looks at the outward appearance," which is personality, "but the Lord looks at the heart," which is character. Besides heart, you write character. And above that, you write personality. And God's intention is to build your character, not to polish your personality. God's intention is to build my character. Let us pray for the word that we heard and received. While the world is focused upon shaping personalities, showcasing personalities, God is in the business of taking all kinds of personalities and wanting to develop His character in them, to be displayed to this world that they belong to Him. And there are many of you here who have accepted Jesus as your Savior. Remember, God wants to develop His character in you and me, to build you and me. So stay focused on that and say, Lord, I want to be a man and a woman of integrity and virtue. And for those who have not given your lives to the Lord, I encourage you to repent for that sinful nature and surrender your lives at the cross of Calvary. Loving Heavenly Father, we thank you, Lord, for your word. Your word is so true. It's full of life. And thank you for speaking to us as you always do. That we focus on building that godly character in us than the outward appearance, which, Lord, fades away, which doesn't make any sense whatsoever. We commit ourselves to you so that you could develop us into your likeness. In Jesus' precious name I pray. Amen.